So we looked at Merkley Dam Guard, which is a construction to make an iterative hash function out of a fixed length compression function. Now, another such construction like Merkley Dam Guard is the Haifa construction, which was introduced because it turns out Merkley Dam Guard construction has some security issues. One of them we'll see in a later video. So the Haifa framework, or hash iterative framework, is very similar to the Merkley Dam Guard construction. It just adds two parameters, namely the salt value and the number of bits already consumed. So yeah, the number of bits that it already hashed, and the salt value is a predefined value that you can set per hash function family. Well, the number of bits is mainly there to prevent a certain type of attack, so-called fixed points attacks, or to make it at least harder to exploit those. And a salt, well, it's just a predefined value per hash function family, so in order to have different salts for different applications, you can prevent certain pre-computation for certain attacks, because you would need to pre-compute for every application that uses a different salt. So length extension attacks can be avoided. We'll see what length extension attacks are in a later video, and they can be avoided because the compression function knows if it's in the last block, since it knows the already consumed bits and it knows the length of the overall message. So it can finalize in the last iteration step here. Can finalize it, let's say. So Haifa padding is very similar to length extension padding, only that the length of the output hash is also appended, because the Haifa construction encourages hash functions to have a variable length output.